With all these different walleye techniques, it bears mentioning that there are the right tools for specific jobs. And if you're fishing a bunch of these different patterns out on the water, you better have the right rod, reel, and bait combinations to be able to really make hay out there. And these are four rods modeled to specific patterns that I can't live without. First and foremost, conventional rigging. If I'm rigging live bait out there, I've got a really simple setup with a hook, I've got a bullet sinker, but this rod is the right tool for the job because it's 7 feet long, number one. I can really sweep hook sets, I can be away from the boat. And if you look at this fast action, you can see where that rod bends. It's just enough give to detect bites, but plenty of backbone to be able to set hooks. And as a medium light power, it's really able to handle the weights that I'm gonna be rigging with when fishing a variety of depths. So rigging is covered, but how about jigging? When I'm jig fishing, the ultimate is an extra fast action. Now, if you look at that tip, the bend is only at the bottom six, eight inches or so. And that's critical when you're jig fishing. Right now, this is a 6'8" medium extra fast action rod. And again, that's critical because as soon as I lift that rod, I get to backbone and I can drive hooks home into walleyes that are shallow or deep. Now, if we look at another specialized situation, we talk about crankbaits and throwing crankbaits, and specifically this one is a balsa crankbait. These balsa crankbaits or even plastic crankbaits sometimes have a hard time with wind knots, tangling when you throw them. This rod is the perfect solution to that situation. This is a medium power, moderate action rod. Now, this is a completely different rod than those others. At a moderate action, you'll see the bend actually breaks way up the blank, and this is a different material. It's actually made of glass. Now this glass action rod is gonna have a lot of load, a lot of feel yet at the same time because it's exquisitely lightweight, but the key part with crankbait fishing, it's gonna have sufficient give so we can both pull baits through water and not have hooks give or rip out of those fish's mouths when they do eat, and that's really important for crankbait fishing. Now, again, one of the favorite techniques is definitely spinner fishing. This is a bounce and troll, or really bottom bouncer and crankbait trolling specific rod. It's a 7-foot rod, medium heavy power, and that's important because we're gonna have a lot of pull with the diving bill of the crankbait. We're also gonna have a lot of pull with the weight of that bottom bouncer we're dealing with. Now, when we're pulling spinners, we also need that moderate action, so again, that bend is about a third, almost halfway up the rod, so there's a lot of give in this rod, so we don't pull hooks, so we give them the proper presentation. And really, for all four of these, for rigging, for jigging, for casting crankbaits, or for pulling spinner rigs, you need the right tools for the job, the right rod for the right situation.